Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create sprint in Jira using REST API. Creating a future sprint or sprint with the name and origin board ID is required. To start date, end date, and goal are optionals. When we are creating a sprint, name is trimmed. Also, when starting sprints from the UI, end date set through the call is ignored, and instead the last sprint duration is used to fill the form. So we'll see here how to create a sprint through REST API in Jira. For creating this, we have to authenticate Jira connections through REST API. Here we are using Postman for authentication or setting connections or sending a request. So we'll see here how to create a sprint practically. So this is our endpoint. Generally, for creation of endpoint, we have to copy the domain name, and post that we have to add this path. So for creation of the sprint, we don't need this. We have to take this about, and for most important part, we have to create an API in Jira and authorize it in two authorization sections with the API key and token number. That you can see it in my previous video. I will also include the URL in description tab. And domain name, you will get it from here. So this will becomes our any path. And here we have to define the body, what we want inside the sprint when we are creating. So generally, I am copying and pasting this detail. So I will explain you. Hold on. So this is my sprint body. We don't need this one because it's not required. Now, next thing, again, this is not needed. Here we need to have origin board ID. That we will get it from the projects when we are extracting the detail or when we are capturing any particular details. If you want to extract the board, simply give the path as board and send get command. We will get all the board details here. Make sure you are selecting the next generation projects. So this is our board ID. We are working on team board. So this is how we'll get the board details. Now we have to work on sprint. So again, I will change the path and send the details. Now here we are using get method, but for creating a sprint we'll use post method. Origin board ID, we got it from this request, that is 3. Goal, which goal we want to set it up. So this is our sprint 4 goal. I'm setting up end date. So end date, we have to specify it. So let's see, my end date is 4th. Let me keep this as a 5th. Maybe we'll keep 5th of October, and starting date I am keeping exactly 1 week earlier, that is 28th. So 28th of September. So 09, is that clear? So sprint, we are giving the name as sprint 4. So now it's done. This is our timestamp. In which timestamp we want to create it, we have to specify it. And once we are done, we have to click on send. That will send a request to create a sprint. But let's see, do we have that sprint available or not? So as of now in this board, we can see sprint 3, TM sprint 1. Only these two sprints are available with exact date. But here, once we'll send this command, we don't want this. Once we'll send the command, this will create complete sprint with the details. So this is our response ID. State is future, because here we have specified the start date and end date, because we have not activated it. So you can see we got sprint 4, 28th September to 4th of October. We have not started the sprint. That's the reason. If we will complete this, maybe move into sprint 4. So now we have the issues which is assigned to sprint 4. If I want to call out the data of the sprint, maybe we will need the sprint ID. So just add 50 after that and hit get call. Now we got exactly same detail. This is not a future sprint. So we have not started the sprint. Let me start. Okay, click on start the sprint and we have this detail available. Let me send this detail again and we can see the state it's changed to active. So this is how we can create a sprint and make that sprint active. This is extracting detail through get method. Now if we want to delete the sprint, simply what I will do, I will select delete method and click on send. So that sprint will be permanently deleted. And when I will navigate it back to the sprint board, I won't be able to see that sprint is available. Even if I will extract the detail or through get method, we won't find that sprint is available. So this is how we can create, delete and extract the data from any particular sprint through REST API in Jira. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share with the new circle. Thank you for watching.